Good Sunday morning, everybody. Election Day is almost here, and we continue our commitment 2008 coverage right here on First News. A few weeks ago, we brought you the Democrat for Missouri Governor, Attorney General Jay Nixon. This morning, the Republican who wants that same job. Congressman Kenny Hulshof of Columbia, former special prosecutor in the office of the Missouri Attorney General, prosecuting some of the state's highest profile cases, elected to Congress in 96 from Missouri's 9th Congressional District. And Kenny Hulshof is back here with us this morning. Last time we chatted was before the primaries. Good to have you back.
It's great to be back.
All right. The economy is obviously priority one with everybody. There are people in your party, especially at the top of the ticket, John McCain, who have criticized the Bush administration for, in part, for why the economy is in the mess that it is right now. Do you hold the Bush administration accountable for where we are right now?
I hold a lot of the derivative selling, the innovative things happening in Wall Street, assuming that the market was always going to go up, and I hold them accountable. And here's the thing, instead of the finger pointing, what are we going to do to make sure this doesn't happen again? I voted against the $700 billion bailout twice.
Right.
I felt that there was a much more prudent way to do this. In fact, even have Wall Street help bail itself out through an insurance idea rather than having you as the taxpayer on the hook.
And as we sit here on a Sunday morning, of course, early in the week, we saw the Bush administration implement elements of the bailout plan. And we saw on Monday the Wall Street react with a 930-some-odd point gain. When you look at the bailout and you look at the reaction, especially early on in the week, what's wrong with this picture?
Well, what's wrong with this picture as it relates to Missourians is, you know, let's deal with the situation with Wall Street and let that work itself out.
And was it the size of the bailout that bothered you?
It was a number of things. It was the size of the bailout. It was, which a number seemed to be pulled out of thin air, unfortunately, by the Treasury Department. It was the fact that Congress was only going to get to veto the final version of it. Let's stay involved with this, even if it means Congress has to be back in session. And there were some other changes that I would have preferred. Back in the 80s, Kris, there was a private sector way of doing this with the FDIC. To me, that would have been a much more prudent approach. But Secretary Paulson, working with Speaker Pelosi, became fixated on this one idea.
Okay, so you voted against the bailout, and was that a tough vote for you? Again, going against people in your own party.
Going against people in my own party, but again, you stand on your principles and you represent your constituents, which I did. I think, though, Missourians, of course, are quite anxious about our own economic climate. And as in this race for governor, we put forward some pretty specific ideas about how we make sure that we continue to grow our economy here at home.
You have talked, especially in some of your advertising, at least over on this side of the state, about the Kansas City, Missouri school district and the problems which are obviously very well known to this audience.
Yeah.
As governor of the state of Missouri, what could you do to make sure that kids stay in class, to make sure that test scores go up, What can a governor do?
First of all, acknowledge there's a problem. I mean, the Attorney General, with all respect, has been AWOL on this issue. And the fact is, in order to get this done, Kris, it means taking on the special interest in the status quo. We've got 18,000 kids that the school is failing. And so sometimes that means you've got to take on some sacred cows
but
in order to take this.
Attorney General, though, is it fair to criticize Jay Nixon for maybe not necessarily paying a whole lot of attention to the Kansas City, Missouri school district when, in all fairness, there probably isn't a whole lot for an attorney general to do when it comes to public education?
All I know is when he ran for attorney general in 1992, made a lot of promises about what was going to happen with the whole desegregation case and turned his back on those students in. But let's don't look backwards. Let's look forward. What we need to do is to be very aggressive with expanding the opportunities of choice. And I talk about charter schools. And making sure that charter schools are taxpayer-funded schools, holding them accountable. We have to give some flexibility to the teachers, to the principals. And what is wrong with rewarding teachers, merit pay increases? There are a lot of teachers right now, Kris, that are contemplating leaving the school district. Already we've seen school board members themselves throwing up their hands and saying, you know, we just can't deal with this. So this is going to require some political courage to take on, again, some of the powerful special interests who want to leave things as they are. We are failing our kids, not letter grade failing, but we have 18,000 kids in the inner city that are being passed by with this basic civil right, and that is of having a good quality education.
If you were elected governor tomorrow, would you favor a state takeover of the Kansas City, Missouri school district?
Well, we're heading toward that loss of accreditation. And what's interesting is the activists over here watching what's happening in St. Louis, and they're in the midst of the state takeover. And some interesting things developing over in St. Louis, but it may not be that what's happening in St. Louis is right for Kansas City.
But do you think it's necessary in Kansas City, Missouri situation?
We would much prefer, of course, the locals to get involved, but absent this leadership or the ability to get it right, absolutely, we will have to do it. And it's unfortunate. But I will tell you, I'm not going to be the superintendent in chief.
So you favor a state takeover of this district?
If this, by 2010, we're going to know whether or not the school district loses its accreditation. Let's wait and see. We welcome progress. We hope that there's progress, not just in the numbers and scores, but we hope there's progress because of the kids that are there, you know, that we've relegated to this very difficult situation.
There's a Survey USA poll out that came out last week that has you down 22 points to Jay Nixon. Now, granted, it should be noted that there were more Democrats polled in this particular survey than there were Republicans, but still, 22 points is a pretty sizable gap, and among independents, you're down 20. Is this race over?
Absolutely not. In fact, well, with respect to the polling, I've seen numbers all over the map. I've seen single digits, we're closing the gap. What's happening on Wall Street, you know, is caused some angst. And so the whole idea of a change message is resonating, certainly with Senator Obama. But how does one be the longest serving person in state government, the attorney general, who has been part of the status quo for all these years, somehow become an agent of change? I've put forward some very bold proposals about growing our economy, dealing with our inner city schools, energy, healthcare, higher education. I mean, we have some great opportunities, some challenges, but we have to have someone who has the integrity and the political courage to take these challenges on, and we put forward these bold proposals, and the polling data is all over the map. And I think the ultimate poll, of course, is in, as you and I speak today, just a couple of weeks away.
Kenny Hulshof, Republican for Missouri Governor. Good to have you here. Appreciate the time.
Great to be back.
Thank you. Back to you.